Today I'm super excited because it's my first YouTube video. So I purposely saved this video because something just recently happened a week ago exactly that honestly changed my life. It was the best decision my fiance and I could have made together. So yeah, let's get into it. The topic we're getting into is plastic surgery. So if you're into or interested or thinking about getting plastic surgery, keep watching this video, especially during this COVID time because things are crazy. It's 2020 and who would know Corona would come and mess our lives up. So yes, if you're not into plastic surgery, then don't watch, don't hate. Like, I don't need that. We don't need that. It's all good energy. Women empowering women, okay? So let's get into it. I'm so excited. Thank you guys for tuning in. So yes, last week, Thursday, August 20th at 5 a.m., I went and got a breast augmentation, as you can see. I'm super, super excited and happy with my results. I'm just gonna give you guys some background information. I've always wanted my boobs done since I could remember, especially like 16. Like, I hit puberty pretty early when I was like 9, and then I had grew some tatas and was feeling myself, and then like I hit about like 12, 13, and then like everything stopped. I'm like literally still like very small petite girl. I'm only 5'1", maybe 125 pounds, like give or take, depending on like my weight. Definitely goes up and down. Right now I'm probably like 125 on the thicker side because I've gained some weight. But yeah, so I've always wanted my boobs done. Like, I literally stopped growing boobs. I've had the same size boobs grow like high school. Then when I had my son very young, I had my first son Hunter at 19. I had him very young. And you know, your body changes, especially with your first baby. So I really wasn't happy and I was still young. Then I met my fiance and we had 2 children together. So I have a total of 3 kids. My oldest is now 8. So it was time. Okay. It was has to. For me personally, as a woman, I'm gonna be honest, I was so insecure. I was insecure about that one part of my body. If I could change that, that was the one thing that I would change. When I walked in the mirror, it wasn't even like I could take the stretch marks and all of that. Like, when I walked in the mirror, I literally was not happy at all. I went wedding dress shopping with my mom, and we were trying on different dresses, and honestly, y'all, it was like the worst feeling ever. I didn't even feel like a woman. I felt like a little girl, like putting on a wedding dress, playing dress up. It didn't feel real. It was like a really bad feeling. Nothing was fitting me right. It just wasn't a good look. My cousin, shout out to her, Shanice. She lives in Miami, and during Super Bowl weekend that was held here in Atlanta, her and her friend came out, and her sister, who's also my other cousin, Shannon, they came out and visit, and as I'm talking to her friend was like, yeah, I got my boobs done. You know, everybody gets their body done in Miami. It's super cheap. You know, it's very affordable. A lot of people go and get them done. So I'm like, you got your boobs done? Like, y'all, her boobs look so good, like so real. It fit her to a T. So I was like, girl, I need some more information. Like, tell me more. I've been wanting my boobs done for forever. So let me know. So she was telling me how she went through a place called My Cosmetic Surgery, and she went through a doctor called Dr. Laurenti. I believe that's his name. So I talked to my fiance. It had happened that, you know, he got a promotion at work and got some extra money, so he was able to afford my breast augmentation for me. So he paid for it, and he gave me the deposit. So the deposit, I did go with My Cosmetic Surgery. I did a ton of research on them. I'm not gonna lie, like some of the comments, like, okay, the comments about their customer service was not that great, but the comments about like their work, a lot of girls liked their work. And I did see Dr. Lamonte's name a lot. I followed their Instagram page. I would like stalk their page. I'm not even gonna lie. So I finally gave him a call. I paid $500 for my deposit and to set my date. My original date was April 12th, I believe, somewhere in there. I think so. Don't quote me on that, but I'll have another video posted after 1 month. So this is 1 week. I'll do a 1 month, and then I'll give you guys more details on dates if you want that. So as you know, COVID came, and also I'm going to talk about my coordinator. You get a coordinator. Well, like when you call, you get a coordinator. I had Rosa. That lady is literally a godsend. She was amazing. Like, I hear horror stories about other facilities and their coordinators, like, not really caring, not really picking up the phone. No, Rosa was on it, okay? If I called her, if I didn't get her right away, I just left the message. Homegirl was calling me back, okay? Any question I had, she was there. She literally walked with me, held my hand the whole way through. Like, literally, and we did have some hiccups down the road, and I'm going to talk about that as well. So she was telling me also, like, as I'm on the phone with her, like, you want to go ahead and get your deposit, set it now, because, like, everyone's getting their body done. Everybody wants plastic surgery, so the prices every day are going up, 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 and up, 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 and up. And I knew that I didn't, like, saline, I think it's a little bit safer because it's water-based. So, like, if you get into a car accident and, you know, anything ruptures, anything, you know, that's just water, salt water, like, seeping into you. But if you get gel, you know, that's a little bit more gel. However, gel is more natural looking. And because I'm super small and petite, I wanted something a little bit more natural. So I went with the gel implants, the gummy bear implants, which everyone's pretty much getting nowadays. And I paid a total of $3,800 just for the surgery. I got 300 cc's in each breast, and I'll talk about that more too, because people are like, 300 cc's, that's not a lot. But as I told you, y'all, I'm literally only 5'1", if that, okay? And I'm only 125 pounds, if that. So I literally had like nothing. It was like a little bit of skin because I did breastfeed 3 kids, but it was literally nothing. So for me, 300 cc's, literally, like, this is good. Anything bigger would make me look unproportionate, honestly. So I'm glad the doctor, and I'm going to talk about that too, because some things had changed. I originally wanted to go with Dr. Laurenti, but I ended up going with Dr. Luke Gutwine. And honestly, I'm so glad that I did, because he literally was able to look at my body, talk to me, and tell me exactly like what he could do for me with my, you know, body shape and frame. And I'm so glad he went natural with the natural look. I'm not out here looking crazy or whatever. So shout out to him, because he really did a good job. Also, he wanted to be super safe. So like I was saying, I originally went, so surgery got canceled in April. I went in with some friends. Shout out to Javette, Kayla, and Shakara, who went out with me the first time to get surgery, the first time. I had Nexplanon birth control in my arm, like right here. And prior to going, they do like 15 days before surgery, they give you a list of things you cannot do. You cannot smoke, like absolutely no nicotine whatsoever. You cannot drink, you cannot take ibuprofen, you cannot do different teas, like herbal teas. You have to take certain vitamins. I also paid $82 on vitamins alone. You have to get vitamin C, you have to get something for your iron, something to help your blood. I also got like this herbal drink thing, and I'll take a picture and post it below so you guys can see the different medications. And those were just the vitamins. We're not even getting into the medications after surgery. I currently live in Atlanta, Georgia, or like in the Kennesaw area. So I had to buy a flight too. And also, you know, I bought a flight for, you know, my other friend, so she could go too. And hotel and whatever. So when I went, in the list, it does say no birth control, but I guess I wasn't thinking that because it's in my arm, it's not like the pill or a shot. So like the Dr. Luke Goodwin was like, no, like he was not touching me, which I appreciate because he, you know, they just want to be safe. They want to make sure that you're safe and they're safe. Like everybody's being safe because it is major surgery. It's not like going to the hair salon and getting your hair done. Like it's literally surgery. So I do appreciate him, you know, not wanting to do the surgery. At first I was devastated. Like I was like, we paid all this money. Like I'm not going to get my surgery, like freaking out. But I went back 2 months later. Also, when I went in June, when I got there, I did an x-ray. I believe I paid $50. Also getting into COVID, because it is COVID, you have to do, especially if you're out of state patient, if you're an out-of-state patient going to get surgery, you have to do a COVID test. I originally paid, I believe, $85 for the COVID test, and that was the one that went up your nose. That was the worst feeling ever. Like, I believe he had to do it 2 times because the first time, oh my goodness. I have a video, so I'll post that as well so you guys can see that. So, I paid $50 for an x-ray. I paid $85 for the COVID test. I also had to pay $100 clearance from their doctor to say, she's good to go. Like everything's okay. And also they did labs. So, but I believe the labs was included in the $3,800. I'm not technically sure, so don't quote me on that. But, yes, so that was just for, you know, those two. I also prepaid and we spent $40 on a surgical bra. Also keep in mind, I paid $40 for compression socks. Like, I think she was saying 14, but I'm not sure because like there is a language barrier, but I know I paid $40 for compression socks. So, if I were you, I would get your compression socks prior. Like I did with, if I would have known, I would have did the same thing like I did with the bra, and I paid like $40 on Amazon. And I got the surgical bra. So since he wanted to reschedule my surgery to take the birth control out, I had to come back. And I went like 2 months after. So yeah, cause July, August. So we set a new surgery date for August 20th, which was a Thursday. So I flew out on a Tuesday, and because everything, like your labs can be 3 months up to date. So I was good. I didn't have to do the x-ray. The only thing I had to do was the corona test. And since Miami was a hot spot for corona tests, this time that I went, I was able to pay only $50 and get it a blood test instead of the nose. So that was a plus. Ooh. So of course it came back negative. Also, the day of surgery, you have to take a nicotine test, a pregnancy test, and a drug test to make sure everything is good. You know, they will not touch you for real if you don't pass those things, especially the nicotine and all of it. They won't touch you, period. So, and then I went in for surgery, you know, the anesthesia. I woke up after that. They wheeled me out to my sister. Everything was fine. I do hear some horror stories with other facilities, not necessarily with this one, because this one honestly has really good reviews. Even, especially, I picked this one because it has really good reviews on their Better Business Bureau. So, keep that in mind. I just want to say, like honestly, a really big shout out to Rosa over there. She literally did an amazing job. Even when I had to get my birth control out and was freaking out, like, she was really there, like, trying to help the situation, trying to figure out, like, what we could do or whatever. So she was really great. The doctor, Luke Gutenwein, he was great. He was amazing. Like, I really appreciate, like, how he took the time out. People say, you know, you get what you pay for. I didn't pay that much money. We paid $3,800, and honestly, the service was good for when I went. The women there were very nice. The facility is really nice. I'm going to be honest. When you walk in, when I first went, I was a little, like taken back a little bit because it's in a shopping center, like the first facility. But then when you walk in, it's like really nice. It's very well lit. It looks like a spa. It honestly looks like a day spa. It has nice purples in it. It's really nice. I do believe that they do facials there and, you know, other things as well. Would I be back? There's also another facility that I went to. There, it's not as nice as the first facility, but it's still really good. That's where I had my actual surgery at. You might get like a little freaked out because you see like women who have their BBLs, they might have their, you know, drain bags, or women, you know, get the, who just have gotten their breasts done. So, you know, I don't know. But you may or may not. I don't know. But then, like, you get so excited, like, oh, I'm about to get my surgery done. You know, I'm going to get, you know, feel like a brand new person. I wanted to speak on the facility, price. The hotel I stayed at was also really, really nice. They did a really good job. I recommend renting a car. The first time we did Ubers, and they did add up. So that was my experience during like COVID, getting my boobs done and my journey. So I'm gonna follow back up with you guys at 1 month post-op. This is my 1 week post-op, and you know, to me, they're looking great. I'm very happy with my results. I'll show you guys like a little bit, if you could see there, a little bit of the, you know, things. I have to keep this bra on for 3 months. I can't work out for a month, so I am getting a little pudgy. I cannot wait till I can start working out again. If you have any questions or comments, drop them so I can read them. So for my next video, you know, we can go over that. So thank you guys for tuning into the Nye Experience, and check out the next video.
Just chill. Breathe. Ooh. Okay. That shit made me feel bad.